charge of education in this club. Usually the meeting is started by our president, but he is running late. Maybe you will see him after the meeting ends. Come. It's fine. It's safe. It's safe. Exactly. So, welcome. I'm seeing some new faces. Who's here for the first time? Okay. Where did you hear about us?
About the internet.
Mentioned something when our guest came in, and she said, "Come, it's safe." This is a mission of ours to create a safe environment in which we are welcoming people to the second scariest thing in life after death, which is public speaking. Welcoming them in front of you and encourage them to talk about their passions and their ideas. You will see today a lot of people coming in front of you. We will have prepared speeches, we will have a lot of people evaluating them. You'll have 2 hours of fun, I hope. After the 2 hours, after the meeting, you will have the opportunity to give us feedback. We have an online platform. Which we'll use during the meeting, so you'll get familiar with it by the end of the meeting. And you can tell us how it was, if you want to share at the end of the meeting face-to-face how it was, we're going to ask you to do that. Okay, so with no further ado, I will welcome the evening's guest and the person who organized this meeting, Jakub Orjan.
Thank you. Good evening. How was your day?
Wonderful.
Cool. Okay. When someone asked me how was my day, always I tell, unbelievable. So, how was your day? What are your feelings now? Yes, okay. Okay. You know, every day we are disturbed. All it's happened around us. So now if you want to have a lot of energy, we need to know at what things we have to concentrate. So every day we need to concentrate at something which increase our energy. How we do this? Because we don't know. Now nobody asked us, tell us how to concentrate. Everybody asked to concentrate. Everybody told us, concentrate and do your homework, concentrate and do your job. But nobody tell us how to do this. If you want to be good at concentrating, we need to know how our mind works. And to know how mind works, we need to know what is our mind and what is awareness. So, imagine that our mind to be a huge vertical plane. And in this plan, all our feelings, all our jobs, all our tasks, all everything we can imagine is put on this plan. This is our mind. And awareness, imagine that is a flashlight we have in our hand. And when we want something from our mind, from the plan, we lighting with our freshness that things. And as we keep this flashlight, what I call awareness on that things, we became aware. We know, and we know that things. So, to be concentrated is to be able to keep our awareness, our flashlight on that things a long period of time. And how can develop this? We develop this practicing this concentration during the days. And every time when you interact with someone, keep our awareness on that. If our awareness is go away, gently bring it back. Go away, gently bring it back. And keep all our attention on that person, on that things during the day. So we develop in this way our skills to concentrate. So today, how can develop these skills? We develop these skills being concentrated at what is happening here in front. So, let me tell you what it's happened this evening here in front. We have two main sections. First section is prepare speeches, and the second section is evaluation. Evaluation for speeches. And between them, we will have a break and impromptu speeches. Everyone who performs here in front, he will be evaluated. So to invite here in front the evaluator, the technical evaluators, to present their role, I want to thank you to Florin Tipechuk, who helped me to welcome all our guests. So, at every meeting we have a meeting question. And this evening the question is, let me to see what is the question, because I don't know. I prepare the question. Yes, how do you control your mind? How do you control your mind? So Florin told me that his answer is by making peace and becoming friend with her. Okay, now I will invite here in front the technical evaluators to present their role. First technical evaluator is Mircea Moldovan, who is general evaluator. At the meeting question, Mircea gave us the answer, my mind controls me. Mircea Moldovan.
Hello everybody. My role today is to have an overview of everything what happened here from the point of view of technical part. So we have the technical evaluator, and I have to offer them a technical evaluation after they present their role. And for Toastmasters also, and our table topics. At the panel of meeting, I will come back here and present the report. Jakob,
thank you. The second technical evaluator is Ioana Necșa. One minute. At the meeting question, Ioana, give us the answer. I usually take a moment, break, and intentionally become aware of what is happening in my head. Ioana, thank you.
I did the same when I started running. So my role today is the role of a grammarian. I am here to watch your language and make sure that you use proper English. And also, because words are powerful and because it's a great speech is full of a lot of words, not just the common ground of words, I'm going to teach you, I hope, one new word. When I searched for the word of the evening, I said concentration, and I went to meditation, control your mind, and then I said, okay, but who does all that? And I said, okay, the brain. But yeah, but everybody knows the word brain, so how can I teach you brain? And then I remember the fact that brain, which is the, do you know what the brain is? has meaning that's not, like a figurative way of saying, and you can tell, you can say brains, and that means intellectual capacity and intellectual capacity. I will use it in a sentence and try to underline the difference between the two. The phrase is, my brains were in the right place when I decided to join Toastmasters in order for my brain not to freeze when I deliver a speech. Mm. Use it wisely. Thank you.
The third technical evaluator is Răzvan Farcaș, who is our A counter. So, at the meeting question, Răzvan, give us the answer. I don't necessarily control my mind. It is more like a collaboration. I let her roam free and I act on the good ideas. Răzvan Farcaș.
Hello everyone. So my role as an A counter is to support a fluent speech. You know those moments when you're in front and for a very, very short period of time, your brain goes blank? And then the same brain tries to fill the moment with some random interjections, sounds, or even prolonged words like, you know, maybe. Well, that's why I'm here. I'm here to observe those moments and write them down and report them back to you so you can further improve your public speaking abilities. Thank you, and I'll see you again in this evaluation section.
The fourth technical evaluator is Cristina Tipeciuc, who is our timer. So, at the meeting question, Cristina, give us the answer. As soon as I become aware of any undesirable thought, I'm replacing them with opposite ones. Mm-hmm. Cristina Tipeciuc.
Good evening, everybody. This is my first time here, so I'm kind of a brain fog. I have used the word. As your timer this evening, I will track your progress in your progress in time management areas. Why time management is important? Because if we try to fit in the time allocated for each one of us, every speaker on the agenda will have the opportunity to express their opinions or their prepared speeches while keeping this meeting efficient. I will use three cards here. Green card will be for the prepared speeches when table topic speakers and eight counters, team minus 1 minute. And also for the speech evaluator, by team minus 1 minute. General evaluator and grammarian, team minus 2 minutes. Yellow card will be team minus 1 minute prepared speeches, team minus 30 seconds. Eight counters and table topic speakers, team minus 30 seconds speech evaluators, and team minus 1 minute general evaluator and grammarian. Last but not least, the red card. When each allocated time per each kind of speech has been reached, my recommendation is to try and close up anytime you see this card. Please try to fit in your recommended time. I will come back at the end of our session with my report. Thank you very much.
Now we start the prepared speeches. So, I will invite here the first speaker for this evening, who is Laura Lum. At the meeting questions, Laura gave us the answer. I don't want to control my mind. It is one of my best tools, but I do want to sharpen this tool. What I do want to control are some of my thoughts and don't bring me fulfillment. What?
Yes.
Okay. Do you understand my English?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. The title of speech is Loneliness Taboo in Our Modern Life. Her pathways is presentation mastery and is the second speech. The objective with this speech is to include the feedback from the first speech in another speech. Her speech will be evaluated by our colleague Radu Ibieș. Laura Lumu and Loneliness Taboo in Our Life.
I was in this weekend in the I was surrounded with a lot of people, hundreds of people, and coming back to loneliness after my pause, surrounded by this amount of people that I didn't know, that they were rushing, they were checking their phones. And I felt in the middle of all these people lonely. And this is my biggest memory about loneliness. And I think it's curious because it's kind of a cliche story to share with you, because, and it's curious because you can feel lonely in the middle of hundreds of people or in solitude when you don't talk with other persons. Loneliness is really a taboo in our modern life, as I thought about it, because we don't, it's a bit of an embarrassment to talk about because it triggers this idea of pity. And it's a shame a bit because it is a source of suffering, a lot of suffering in our modern life. And it's a bit like an epidemic if you think about it, because we are living in a time where we have a lot of social apps with which we can reach out into the world and talk and connect. And still, I think it masks this epidemic. Why? Because, for example, with Facebook, we can see all our friends' pictures with people. They are trying to say, okay, here I am surrounded by all our friends, all of these people, we have company, right? And every one of us is doing this PR work, like to show on Facebook. And this is how loneliness is covered. I want to dispel two things in my speech. The first one is we should think about loneliness as a thing that is shared by a lot of people. And we should stop or shatter this obsession we have, that we have this experience of life, this emotion, that nobody else shares, when in fact is the opposite. And it's important to talk about because we have different types of loneliness. For example, we have people who don't have parents, people who don't have a daughter, a friend, a good relationship. And even another type of loneliness is having one idea that nobody else shares with you, or at least with your peers or your community. Still, giving all these types, for sure everyone feels this from time to time, so it's something that everyone experiences. Another question I have, the second as well that I want to present is it loneliness such a bad thing? It depends, right?
Yeah.
I think of this emotion as being an opportunity to grow, because you can stay in your space, like a solitude place just for you, and think about better ways to deal with, better ways or better solution to present to the other, to have another feedback for people after you've done your introspection. And it's something, it's like a gift given to other people. There is one German poet, Jan Reich, who worked a lot, have written a lot of poems about solitude, and he found it wonderful. I will finish my speech with one main idea, that solitude is something that everyone shares, and it's kind of the secret to deal with it. And it's an opportunity to grow. And realizing this, we can be kinder to each other. From this experience, knowing the bigger picture, we can be kinder to each other. And take my message this evening like a pressure valve for the times when you will be lonely. Thank you.
TNC, we will give a feedback for Laura's speech. We have only 1 minute. Thank you. Invite here in front the second speaker from the prepared speeches. At this meeting, the second speaker. speaker is Dragos Gilaniuk. At the meeting question, Dragos, give us the answer. Good question. So, the title of his speech is Steve Jobs, Nelson Mandela, Adolf Hitler. His pathway is dynamic leadership, and is his fifth speech. The objective with this speech is to understand our leadership style, share some aspect of chosen leadership style or leadership style in general, discuss style preferences when working with others, how to adapt the chosen leadership style to situation or leadership style in general, and how they impact the group. The speech will be evaluated by our colleague Horatiu Stangulescu. Dragos Gilaniuk and Steve Jobs, Nelson Mandela, and Adolf Hitler.
Does this work?
Nice, perfect. Steve Jobs, Nelson Mandela, Adolf Hitler. They all remain in history as important leaders that changed the world they lived in, for better or for worse. And generally, we are pretty good at either worshiping or despising them. But in doing that, we ignore the single most crucial aspect of their success, and ironically, the only one that we should truly care about. We ignore that real change can only start with true believers. What do I mean by that? I mean that real change never happens just because someone has an idea. Real change happens because of the people that hear that idea, believe in it, take it into their lives, and spread it everywhere. We wouldn't know the names Steve Jobs, Nelson Mandela, not even Adolf Hitler, if it weren't for the people that spread their vision into their families, in their communities, and even on the battlefield. Of course, all of them have had great merit. Each and every one of them were the spark. But if it wasn't for the fuel of all the people that believed in them, all their ideas would have died just like this. This is why true change, real change, can only happen and begin with true believers. And this is not just a philosophical statement, this is basic common sense. Your friend Johnny will never buy the latest program of meditation just because Bill Gates said that is the secret to his success. But if you happen to believe that, you buy that program, it works for you, and Johnny sees that it works for you, and it turns your life into the perfect life, oh, you can bet he's gonna put his hands on that program. Maybe Bill Gates knew much more about that program than you did. Maybe he had better arguments, better persuasion skills. But for Johnny, he was just the voice of a man that he will never meet in his life. You, on the other hand, you are a concrete part of Johnny's world. He sees you. He shakes your hand. He talks to you. He is influenced by you. This is why for Johnny, you are a far greater leader than one of the richest, most famous, and most influential people in the world. And it was the same for Steve Jobs, Nelson Mandela, and Adolf Hitler. Most of their followers never even met them, but they met their believers, and the rest is history. This is why real change can only start with true believers. But this leaves us with one important question. What does it actually mean to be a believer? Well, obviously, to believe in something great, preferably not a mustache man ready to go to war. But what does it actually mean to truly believe in something? It means to make sacrifices for that something. It means that every single time you make a decision, you think about that something. It means that your habits prove your belief in that something. And this is worth repeating. Truly believing in something means that our habits prove our belief in that something. My friends, real change can only start with true believers. And to become those believers, we first have to control our own habits. But this is the tough part. Controlling our habits is tough because today, In doing that, we are fighting with the corporations that pour in billions of dollars just to give us bad habits and make a profit on them. And this fight seems pretty unfair. They have power, they have the scientists, they have the billions. What do we have? We seem pretty doomed in this fight. But here comes into play my personal belief. I believe that we can win this fight. We can control our habits, and we can become those believers by focusing on only one habit. The most fundamental habit of them all. The habit of eating. And I'm not talking about stop putting junk in your bodies. We all know we shouldn't do that. I'm talking about let's start eating the things that we need so our bodies will become as beautiful and strong as they can get. Our minds as clear and sharp as they can get. Our souls as full of energy and happy as they can get. But sounds good, right? But how do you actually know what should we eat for that to happen? It's not a magical potion. Well, you could go on the internet and take some simple advice that is totally unreliable. Or you could go at a nutritionist and get professional advice that is extremely expensive and hard to follow. And these are pretty much our only options. And no wonder why we can't really take advantage of what we eat. But what if we could combine the simplicity of a Google search with the professionalism of a real nutritionist? What if on the little screens of our phones we can get advice that is simple to follow, professional and personalized to our own needs and wants? What if eating the best food possible for us would be as easy as taking a burger at McDonald's? This is my dream, and that is the problem. Right now it's just a dream. To be able to call that dream a vision and turn it into reality, I need believers. I need leaders, I need all of you. And I'm not saying my friends help me build something great. I'm saying my friends, let's help ourselves. Let's help each other. Let's make eating healthy as easy as... And for that, I would ask you to take your phones out. And please enter this very link in your browsers. It is sbpnutrition.firebaseapp.com. I'll just join you. It's the website where eventually you will be able to find something more about it. But right now it's not about finding something more. I want something else. I want you to get into that website and enter your email out there. You'll have a box where you will be able to. I will join you in this little journey. And just like that, we've made the first step together. Something great. Of course, there are countless more steps to go, but I believe that we can take them. And I believe that together we can build something great right here in Cluj. And wouldn't you want to believe it as well? In conclusion, real change can only start with true believers. To become those believers, we first have to control our own habits. And to control those habits, we need to start with the most fundamental one. And this is hard. But right now, we have a chance to make it easier. My friends, this is the spark that I was talking about in the beginning. And I do believe that together, we won't let that spark die. Instead, together, we will turn that spark into a flame. Let that flame burn. And through that flame, we will make the difference in our world. Thank you. Jakob, the stage is yours.
give feedback on the same application, the same password to Dragos, to speech of Dragos in Anis. 1 minute. Okay, 1 minute passed. Now I will invite the third speaker for this evening. Juana Stanciu is the third speaker. At the meeting question, Juana give us the answer. Mainly, I try to have a dialogue with my mind and let logic win. The title of his speech is My First Cultural Shock. Her pathway is innovative planning and is the sixth speech. The objective with this speech is to connect with the audience, to choose a topic that is unfamiliar to the majority of your audience, practice adapting during the presentation. Monitor the audience reaction to the topic and adapt as necessary to maintain engagement. Now, Sica Petrescu is her evaluator for the speech. Juana Stanciu and my first cultural shock.
Let's take a trip back to our first job. What did your first job mean for you? Did it give you the pride that from now on you can make it on your own and that your parents did a great job until now? Did your first job bring you happiness because you were able to meet so many new people from which you had to learn? Did your first job supply you with all the skills you needed to succeed on the career ladder? I see you are still thinking. I can read it in your eyes. My first job happened when I was 19 and I was a babysitter. So it gave me all of these amazing qualities and something more. It gave me my first cultural shock. Well, do you know what the cultural shock is? Raise your hand. So, a cultural shock is the feeling of disorientation that appears when somebody from a certain culture meets a new culture which does a certain, or many things, totally different. So, what could have happened to me when I was 19 and I was babysitting two German kids? Do you want to find out?
Yes.
Well, maybe by the end of the evening, some other people will want to find out something more. But let's see how the things develop. My first job was taking care of Annabelle, who was 5 years old, and of her younger brother, Frederick, who was 4. They were so full of love, so full of joy, so full of energy. And most of the time, they were listening to what I was telling them because, you know, I was older than them. Until one day, when in the afternoon, while we were playing in their house, Frederick stopped playing, started looking at me with his big eyes, and put a smile on his face. You know, that kind of a smile that tells you that something really bad is about to happen. I want to see your boobies. I have no idea how to react. Like, and then, until I can realize what was happening to me, he jumped for my t-shirt and he was pulling it. I want to see them, I want to see them. In my experience, I have met many men eager to see the goodies. But please, we know how to handle them with the swish swish bang, right? But to a 4-year-old angel, what are you supposed to do? So I was like, no, Frederick, no, down, boy, down, no. And then, with my whole lucidity, I said, stop it, little boys are not allowed to see them. And he calmed down. But then his sister jumped in with a question. What about little girls? My jaw dropped this time. Little girls are not allowed to see them when little boys are around. And for that evening, we were good. Later that night, their mother came, and I wanted to speak with her in private.
Auntie.
Yes. Something strange happened today. What? Frederick wanted to see them. And did you show them? My jar was somewhere on the ground, and I was trying to pick up the pieces. I didn't know I was supposed to or that I'm allowed to. You know, he's just a little boy, it's nothing sexual, and plus yours are bigger than mine, so you just make a game. I have a new bra, and here are my breasts. Thank you. I will think about it. Did it happen to you, Romania? Because in my childhood, if you had the curiosity and someone told you no, you were good to go, then it was a no. In Germany, it was different. Apparently, you showed up. The next 2 weeks, I lived in horror and terror because every day, Frederick had these demands. Show them. I want to see them. I want to see them. Show me, show me, show me. I had no idea what was I supposed to do. In the end, I did the mature thing that a 19-year-old girl was to do with a man. I took him by the hand, put him in his daddy's chair, and asked him, do you really, really, really want to see them? Yes. Okay, you can see them when you turn 18. Okay. And then he did the most incredible thing. He jumped from his daddy's chair, took a blanket, and covered me. Another brain freeze, but this time a positive one. So, in psychology, you're supposed to analyze what has happened. What did you do? What could have gone better? What was supposed to go wrong, but you just got lucky. Maybe sometimes you just analyze a different kind of response. And most important, you get the conclusion. Would you have done something differently? Maybe you tell me in the break. Or maybe if you had such a curiosity, maybe you told me how someone, you know, answered your curiosity. My take-home message from this incident, let's call it like this, was that I said, if he's willing to wait 14 years just to see me in my birthday suit, I'm going to marry him. This is true love. 14 years to wait. Come on, where do you see that? Last month, he turned 18. I'm gonna give him a call.
Now we will have a 5-minute break, and after break we will have. I'm sorry. Now, please give a feedback for one of Manchu speeches. On the same application. Now we have a 5-minute break, and after the break we'll have the section for with impromptu speeches. Marianne Quinzariu, it's our colleague, will conduct a tabletop session. So please find him and put it on his list. And try to be here informed, because you will have a great experience here when you have impromptu speeches. I'm sure Marianne will have a lot of interesting ideas. So, 5 minutes, maybe. Thank you. 5 minutes passed. Now we have the section of impromptu speeches. Our colleague Marianne Quinzariu will conduct this section. So if you are on his list, you will be invited here in front. Now Marianne will explain how the section, the speeches will be performed. So, let's see what is happening. Okay.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
How are you feeling?
Good.
Great.
Good.
So, my role tonight is to have a good time with improv speeches. All the time, you don't need to think about too much. On a speech, just go to the floor, just imagine everything you want, almost everything. So, our this section is regarding 2-minute speeches, where you can speak freely about some question that I prepare in advance for you. And also, we have help from the timer that will show a green card on 1 minute. What on the 1 minute and a half, it will show yellow card, and on the 2 minutes, it will show red card when it's time to finish. Also, you have 20 seconds before to think about the subject, and choose some start points. So I will start with the first speech speaker. Sorry, and the first speak. Is Diana. Big round of applause.
Hello.
So I have seven subject questions. You can choose from 1 to 7.
Okay, that's second.
That's second. Okay. You are in a mental hospital without guardians. How you remain calm? I repeat, you are in a mental hospital without guardians. How you remain calm? You have 10 seconds.
So I'm guessing you already know that you
you are the people in the hospital right now. I'm embodying myself as being the sane one amongst you. And I'm thinking, actually I have this whole belief that people are really crazy in mental hospitals. I just think they're not understood. And if you come to think of it, like, people were thought to be crazy, that were the biggest inventors, the biggest creators, the biggest artists, and they were only understood after their death, most of them. Some of them got lucky. But you guys, I know. And so I'm thinking, first of all, I'm pretty calm. I'm surprising myself that I'm calm right here, so it was a huge shift for me to, like, right in the list and come up here. But I'm pretty calm, so I guess I could be pretty calm in a mental hospital as long as I know I'm not crazy.
How do you know? They don't.
What does it matter what other people hear? That's what Pinter says, at least. So I'm thinking, let's make this game interesting. And let's just think that maybe we can find one person that has a brilliant idea that when I get out of this hospital, I can make a huge business out of it. And then they're gonna be stuck here, and I'll be out here, the innovator, the visionary. And then I'll gather like a group of believers. Like, I learned a lot today, and I'm gonna light up and do all that thing. And then people will know, like, I saw outside of the box when really I was inside of the box. Because we all have like this box inside of our heads that never really gets out because we're so afraid of being thought of crazy or too much or too extreme or too weird. And that's it. I got the rest. Thank you.
Thank you for sharing the information about the hospital. And the next speaker tonight, it is Nicodim. I will invite you to come to the stage. You have been drinking all night, and tomorrow you have exam. How do you focus to learn? I will repeat. You have been drinking all night, and tomorrow you have an exam. How do you focus on learning? You have 20 seconds.
So, I guess I've been drinking a lot, which is not so good before the exam, but today I learned something, that you can use followers to promote an idea. So, my idea is to pass that exam, and I will somehow convince people to help me learn and concentrate. Because it's way easier to learn with other people or to be taught than to learn on yourself. Because being alone in studying kind of sucks. So being drunk will help with socializing. I may make some new friends. We learn together for the exam, maybe go out together after that, make some lifelong friends, just because I've been drinking when I should have been learning alone at home. I think I like baking. Baking sounds like a better idea. I mean, it's pretty sad for me to be home alone the night before the exam and like study like a desperate guy trying to get that 5. It's like insanity. So difficult to approve of that concept for me. I mean, staying up all night studying for the doomsday exam, like, you can't think of anything else. When you have an exam the following day, it's like the apocalypse. Nothing happens. It's just, that's the only thing that matters. The exam. And get that 5. So you'll do anything for the 5. Thank you.
Thank you, Nicodine. I also do anything for 5. So our third speaker tonight, it is Dragos.
Easy. He wasn't my choice.
Give me one.
You have a group of monkey in your head. How you focus?
Like on my...
Yeah.
Inside
your head.
Oh.
Okay.
Thank you.
You need to repeat?
It's right.
Okay. 30 seconds.
You know, it would be very, very nice if I had them on my head because, you know, I had this thing. Okay, sorry. So monkeys in my head. If I had them. If we are honest with ourselves, is this such a hypothetical situation that we have monkeys in our head?
No.
This is exactly my opinion. I mean, okay, it sounds weird that we have monkeys in our head, but let's be honest, how many times do you want to go and just say hi to someone? And then there was just someone, some fucking monkey that held us back. How many times did you want to actually go out there and, you know, just do something, just enjoy, just leave everything, let everything go. But some kind of monkey up there just seemed to, you know, be searching for article, the little things in your head. Yeah.
Lies.
Right. Yeah. So I think this subject is pretty deep if you think about it. Because, like I said, it's not such a hypothetical situation. And the question of how would you deal with the monkeys in your head, I think we would be better asked as, how do you deal with the monkeys in your head? How do you make them shut up when you really want to just do something? How do you silence them at the most important times? And how do you stop them from actually ruining this wonderful life that you get? I think this is the real question. And this answer can be found only between those monkeys, navigating among them. And maybe one of those monkeys will have a secret, or maybe not. Who knows? It's your personal journey. Find out.
Thank you, Dragos, for...
This was so deep, dude.
Yeah.
This was so deep.
I guess it's from the gas.
Talk about crazy.
That is good. Good. Our fourth speaker, it is... How you remember? remain focused and calm when somebody cut your road. I will repeat, how you remain focused and calm when somebody cut your road.
How many of you have a driving license? Okay, good. So I don't know about you, but when someone cuts my road, I'm not very calm at all. I'm a totally different person. I'm swearing a lot. I'm not proud of me. Every time I do that, I just promise myself that next time I'll never do it again. However, next time I'll do it again and again and again, because it's, you know, I can never imagine how that person cannot see me. my car is not very, you know, shiny and bright, but it's my car, and they should see me again. Nevertheless, I think the moral of the story is that you should be more calm than myself. And you know, we have a saying where I was born. So never do what the priest does, do what the priest says. So my advice to you would be to not to swear a lot, to be calmer, to be polite in traffic. I'm trying myself to do that. So far, not so good. yes. This is a story, my story. Hopefully yours is happier and calmer. Thank you.
Thank you. Also, in the beginning, I was not very calm on the driving seat. I was very crazy. So our last speaker tonight, it is a girl, and it is Adelina. So choose four, five, or seven.
Seven.
I guess you've not seen that question. How do you stay calm and focused when you take a cold shower? I will repeat. How do you stay calm and focused when you take a cold shower?
Okay. So we have this coming wars of ours. Sebi, he brought the idea of taking cold showers in order to stimulate our immune system, to reduce the inflammation after you jog. And I've tried it once or twice. But I didn't get a chance to be calm, because every time I'm like, oh, let me stop it. But thinking about how can I be calm and get the benefits of the shower, I don't know, just use the power of mind and thinking that it's warm and perfumed water and it's a pleasure to be there, and thinking about the benefits I'll get, and after I will stop the cold water, the blood will start to flow in my body again and get warmer and be in the warm place and in the safe zone. So that's what I'm thinking I'm gonna do in this case, trying to stay a longer time there. Thank you.
Thank you, Adelina, for cold shower on the stage. So I will invite the Toastmasters to continue our sections.
Thank you.
Thank you.
in applications, people know please vote which speech you like the most. And now it's time to go away to see how great we perform here in front. It's time for evaluators. So we will start with evaluators for the speeches. And the first evaluator is Radu Ilieș, who evaluated the speech for Laura Lungu. And the question of the evening's question, Radu Ilieș gave me an answer, and his answer is, I use questions to direct my attention to what is relevant. Radu Ilieș is invited here from.
Thank you, Jacob. Hello, everybody. We had the pleasure of hearing a very interesting speech about loneliness provided to us by Laura. I would like to dive right into it, and Laura, I would like to mention that I really liked the structure of your speech. I believe the structure that you used could work for a very good speech, for a great speech. And if you remember, she started with a question, you continued with a personal story, you gave us some information, you established a problem, you came with a solution, you continued with a quote, and ended with a memorable message. Now this, in principle, is a structure for a great speech, and you nailed it. The structure. I really liked your introduction. With a question, have you ever felt lonely? And it's so easy to connect with the audience with a question. Have you ever felt in a certain way? Then you continued with your personal story. You mentioned how in Italy you felt lonely in the middle of hundreds of people. And personal stories are so great at both connecting with the audience and delivering your message, because they're so much more personal because they're personal stories. I also appreciate the vocabulary that you used. I heard a few metaphors like loneliness is epidemic, my message like a pressure valve, and it was great. Use more of that, use more metaphoric language. And I also appreciate the sublime ending. Loneliness is an opportunity to grow. And I believe this underlined your main message, which is for us to have a positive outlook on loneliness. Now, in order for this message to be even better received and have a greater impact, a stronger impression, I believe there are a few things which could have been done better. First, the overall impression that I had from your speech, from your delivery, was that it was like teaching or like preaching. You said, my message is, I will leave you with, you used information which is you presented your information as general truth. For example, loneliness triggers the idea of pity. Every one of us is doing this PR work in Facebook. So it was like teaching us about a subject. And sometimes it's useful to have this approach when you establish yourself as an expert in a field. Then you come and teach us. But are you an expert in the field of loneliness? Maybe in this specific case, it would have been easier or better to use more personal stories. Either a story of you or a story of a friend who maybe was sitting there in his chair looking at photos of his friends on Facebook and something. Maybe go that way. Second, you about that quote from the ideal structure, I would have so loved to hear a verse or a stanza from that poet, which suggested that loneliness is wonderful. Third, regarding delivery, I noticed that you moved a lot. You came all the way here, stage is there, you came all the way here, which sometimes is good to come inside of the audience, but it was a bit too much and it felt a bit chaotic. So decide where to move beforehand and only stick to certain areas. And add more vocal variety. In in order to add more vocal variety, what we can do is practice at home, maybe, and each of us can do this when we want to become better vocal variety people. When you see a speech which you like, then try and repeat those words with that tone, with that variety. If you see a speaker which you like or hear, try and say something following that speech pattern, and it will be easier for you. So overall, great structure, very nice vocabulary. Work a bit on the delivery, and maybe also choose a lighter topic for the future, which will allow your brain to focus more on the delivery and less on the content. So lighter topic for the future. Congrats.
Thank you, Rahul. The second speech, Steve Jobs, Nelson Mandela, Adolf Hitler, was presented here in front by Dragos Milani. And you will be evaluated by Horatiu Stanculescu. The evening question, how do you control your mind? Horatiu Stanculescu tell us, I control my mind by controlling my body first. Body awareness can be increased by doing various sports. Horatiu Stanculescu.
Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster. Tonight, Dragos presented us with three personalities and some insights about the food industry. And I will get right to it. Dragos, I'm going to tell you two things you excel at and three things you may want to work upon in order to improve your speech. The first two are as follows. You excel at the beginning. You came here in front, in the middle of the stage, with hands up and open body posture, with a big smile, and you started with confidence. This helped me to attract my attention to you and to follow you throughout the speech. So, great at this part. Also, the second thing is vocal variety. And there are two main things that I noticed. Volume, your voice was heard throughout the whole room, and pronunciation, in which you pointed out in every sentence, there is a key element, a word that you pointed out, in which to attract your clarity towards the speech and make us understand better. So, good job for that. And now, the three things that you may want to work upon are as follows. The first thing, the tech part. I saw that even before beginning your speech, you had some minor difficulties with the laptop or stuff like that. In order to challenge yourself, there is a slight minute before your speech. Use it wisely and come and check if your presentation and your laptop is in tip-top shape, in order to start even better your speech. Now, the second part are the transitions. And I found it a little bit difficult to link the three personalities and the food industry. So I didn't quite catch that. What you can do to do better, the vocal variety stuff with the part with the pause. If you want to say something important, wait for 4 seconds. This will tell your audience something big is up, or another idea pops up. So it's better. Another thing you can do is talk really, really, really fast, or really, really, really slow. That attracts attention, yes. And you have the stage to do this even further. And then there is the third part of the audience awareness. And now I'm going to require all your help. Which one of you heard Dragos' speech? Hearing. Okay. And now, which one of you felt, audience, the Dragos' speech? Who did feel? Okay. So about 60%, I think. 55-60%. You can do this even better. What did you do good? The ideas were good. The delivery was great. But the audience interaction was a little bit like a monologue. You come and teach us and motivate us and tell us to put our phones and search for something. What you can do better is to ask. I don't know, an example would be, which one of you here thinks that eating well makes you a great leader? Damn. So it makes them pop their hands up and engages them. You don't have to do a debate because you don't have time. And to reiterate, I like the beginning, the vocal variety part of the volume and pronunciation, and the three things you may want to work upon in the tech part, the transition part with vocal, even more vocal variety, and the audience response and awareness. I will enjoy your next speech. I feel it.
My first cultural shock was the third speech performed by Oana Stanciu. And this speech will be evaluated by Nausica Petrescu. The question, the evening, Nausica told us, I control my mind by using persuasion techniques. Nausica Petrescu.
Thank you, Jakob. Hello, everyone. So tonight I'm going to tell you how Oana managed to connect with her audience. But first, who here in the audience felt a connection with Oana? Okay, good, thank you. Okay, so I'm gonna switch the order Horatio organized his evaluation by giving you three things I think you excelled at and two things I think you can improve in order to connect better with you. I like the fact that you used visual contact in order to connect with your audience. You also smiled, and that's a good thing. You smiled a lot, and that's also a good thing depending on the situation. When people smile at me, I think it has to be special. It must have a reason. No, not like that, Ronnie. I think either they're telling me a joke, or they talk about something they're passionate about, or they like me or something. But there must be a reason. Sometimes when you smiled during the speech and during some other speeches, you, when you talked about something serious, you smiled. And I think the message, the words you said didn't quite match with your mimic. And trying to match those two brings something, makes the message believable for the public, for the audience. And I would suggest you do that. You try to do that more, like smile less. And also another improvement suggestion I would give you would be to also try to use some less gestures, because you use gestures and that's very good. There are people who don't move at all here in front, but you use a lot of gestures and that distracted me from paying attention to the message you're trying to deliver. So good job on engaging the audience by using visual contact questions, direct and rhetorical questions, by using humor also, and try to work on the smile and the gestures.
Now I would like here in front our grammarian to tell us how good was our English. Ioana Nexa.
Flawless, but she wasn't, and somebody
noticed a mistake I did, and that would be Jakob is the evening's host, not guest, as you might have guessed by now. Jakob, I would like to congratulate you. It's the first time Jakob is being the host in English, and I know this has been challenged, yes, and a fear-charged decision. And I would like to congratulate you because I'm seeing improvement in your English since last year. So congratulations. However, I will tell you that you're not very good friends with S. You told us, tell us, perform with a lot of S's. Like, Adelina tells us something. Christina asks us something. So you have to put an S. Opposite. Just the pronunciation. Congratulations. Not congratulations. Marianne is our colleague. Marianne is our colleague, you said, without the is. Marianne is our colleague. And the same goes with Radu is invited here in front. Radu is invited here. And Horatiu, you said, told us. Horatiu told us. Mircea, again, the first time for being a general evaluator, congratulations. You have the same dislike for S's, I noticed. And you said something like at the final of our meeting, at the end of our meeting. Okay. Răzvan, congratulations, first time for A counter. I noticed nothing. Your English was very good. Christina, congratulations, first time as a timer, and first time ever in a row, as well as Rosman. So double congratulations. Why time management is important? Why is time management important? Just a switch. Laura, I like the way you said loneliness is an epidemic. And also you said something like, everybody does PR work on Facebook. I like that. A opportunity is an opportunity. Whenever you have a word starting with a vowel, you have an, okay, in front. All the things that it's supposed to be beautiful, I will rephrase it in all the things that might be beautiful or are supposed to be beautiful. And you said something like, when you don't talk with other persons, with other people. Okay. Dragoș, I liked the way you said real change can start only with believers. You have very good English. Sometimes you mumble. I'm sorry to tell you. Sometimes you go in that part of the stage. And try to work on that. I didn't hear you do that in Romanian, so maybe it's just a fast.
From the American rappers.
Sorry?
From the American rappers.
From the American rappers, I understand. Okay. Juana, very good English. Only one thing I noticed. You say thing instead of thing. That's it. And also, I heard, let's call it like this. It's a direct translation from Romanian. We all make this mistake. Let's call it so, the more elegant form. Marian. You said something. All the time you don't need to think too much. And I heard it and said it again in my head. I would say something like, usually we don't get the chance to other people's with other people, without the S. Dragos, as table topics. A monkey that holds us back, that holds us back with objects. Petra, you said the same thing as Marianne, because that's the way you heard the topic. Cut my rope. It's cut my way. Okay. Be more calm than myself. Be more calm than me. Adelina, I liked when you said perfumed water. It's a pleasure to be there. Be in the rock. In the warm place, be in a warm place. Okay. Radu, congratulations. I only wrote two things to underline the fact that you have such good English. And I know that when somebody has very good English, because they use the same phrase with different words, like synonyms, you said, a greater impact, a stronger impression. It's the same thing, but said with different words. And also you said a quote or a stanza. I had to Google what a stanza is. Strofo for everybody. Maybe you know it, I do. Horatio, attract my attention, get my attention. What do you do good? I don't know why it sounded wrong at the time. What are the aspects you're good at? And I liked it when you said your laptop is in tip-top shape. I didn't hear this tip-top expression in a long time. Now, Stika, visual contact in English is eye contact.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And you said use some less gestures. Use less gestures. Congratulations to Diana, Christina, and Juana for using brain. Thank you. Yes.
Thank you, Diana. The next technical evaluator is our encounter.
Congratulate those who didn't make it to my list, the guard from the outside. That's the only person that I'm joking. Juana, congratulations. And Dragos, you had a mistake, but it was at the table topics, so I kinda nominate you for this list too. And now, Juana, as a president, you had some mistakes, but it's acceptable because it was on the go, so. you had a few interjections and some sounds, and in total, the grammarian role, you had 13 mistakes. The Toastmaster, Jaco, you had 14 mistakes. You had a few prolonged words, like when, and a few pauses that were not appropriate. The timer, you had two sounds, like the first speaker, Laura, you had 8 mistakes, and you did a really long pause when she showed you the card. You shouldn't get influenced by that much. Dragos, I didn't see any mistakes at the speech, only at the table topics. Juana, congratulations again, I didn't see any mistakes. Radu, you had 5 A's. You really embraced the Horatio, you prolonged two words, to and the. Nausicaa, you had 4 mistakes. You did some repetitions, the, you, and you also prolonged some word, prolonged you 2 times. Marianne, you had 7 mistakes. You prolonged a few words and you said, you repeat, I. Diana, at the table topics, you had 2 mistakes, congratulations, like some sounds. Nicodine, you had 1 mistake, just one up. Dragos, as I said, you had one mistake. Petre, you had four in total. It was och three times, and the it's a prolonged word. And Adelina, you had four. You prolonged three words and you had an A. That's my report. I hope next time I won't see you on my list, and I hope you pay attention to your A's and M's and you know and everything.
Our next technical evaluator is our timer. So I'm back here in front.
The meeting started 2 minutes later. The room was well prepared. We had badges, banners. There were no interruptions, and we enjoyed a lot of silence today. I smelled smoke because of Dragos fire, but not in that one. In spite, it was dangerous. Ivana, you presented your role as a replacement for the president. You present our mission here as a club, what we are doing, what will happen here. You presented yourself as vice president of education, so we know who you are. Jakob, Toastmasters, you try to increase our energy here, trying to connect with us. You ask us to give feedback for speakers, and once we help you remember this, you presented the schedule of this meeting, the technical evaluator, speeching, impromptu speeches. It was a break while you search for the meeting questions. Marianne, as a table topics master, you had a positive and enthusiastic attitude. You started with a high level of energy, trying to capture our attention. You presented in a proper way the whole procedure for this section. You were funny while presenting professional for this kind of activity. You underline every moment of Laura's speech offering a state-of-the-art evaluation. Congratulations. Next time, you could use a tablet because it was hard to read from phone. Horatio, you are one of the pillars for our club. Your evaluation was above my expectations, so nothing to comment on. You offered also a state-of-the-art feedback, as usual, basically. Something to improve, nothing from my point of view. Nausicaa, you were so cold while offering evaluations, but you were right in what you said related to Anna's speech. Razvan, as an aid counter, you presented very clear and nice your role. Also, the same for your feedback. Joanna, as a grammarian, you presented your mission as a grammarian, and as a bonus, you made us laugh. Very nice. You offered us useful feedback. Christina, as a timer, very well role preparation. Congratulations, it was your first technical role above my expectations. Special remarks. Our dear president, Peter, was late today as unusual, but you will meet him at the end of the meeting. That's my report for today.
Now it's time to find our winner at the impromptu speeches. So let's make some noise to increase our energy.
Învățământul nostru e construit. atunci degrab dacă s-ar face engleză și cu competiție, dar să se facă. Nu știu voi cum ați fost, dar... Da. Cursul acesta credem că o să fie foarte fain, așa că vă invităm cu drag și membrii și non-membrii să veniți să vedeți și în alte setup-uri. Ha, nu mai este gramatice aici, mai să folosesc româneză. Tot aici, da. Tot aici, tot de la ora 7, tot noi și alții și într-un pic alt mediu. Dacă, da.
Am răspuns deja. Vreau să întreb câte speech-uri, dar mi-am dat seama că am răspuns.
Foarte bine. Dacă dintre membri sunt colegi care ar vrea să fie jurați, avem discursuri pregătite română și engleză, concurs de evaluare română și engleză. Dacă doriți să fiți jurați, vă rog să-mi scrieți în privat mie. Da. Cronologic, o să vă zic ce se mai întâmplă în luna martie. Pe data de 10 ați văzut probabil că cei de la organizația studențească BEST ne-au invitat să ținem un training acolo, un workshop pe cum să te pregătești pentru un start de carieră și colegele noastre, Cristina, aici de față, și Ildi, pe care membrii o știu, vor merge să livreze acest training la 10 martie. Iai, vă ținem bun. Iacob a fost și-a livrat anul trecut, deci dacă vreți să knowledge share, este momentul. Ok? În 15 martie suntem prezenți la Târgul de Carieră în IT. Dacă vreți să veniți să ne vedeți, să ne susțineți, suntem acolo unii dintre noi și ținem discursuri. În 20 martie există o ședință la Sibiu, unde Nausica ne invită cu căldură să mergem să ne susținem colegii din Toastmasters Sibiu. Putem să ne implicăm și în ședință, nu? Să ne luăm rolul și să ținem discursuri acolo. Dacă aveți chef de un road trip la Sibiu, 20 martie, acolo să fim. 23 martie vom avea următoarea fază a concursului, și anume cea pe arie, se va ține la Brașov. Deci dacă doriți să vedeți ce se întâmplă cu concurenții de săptămâna viitoare mai departe, la Brașov o să fie următoarea fază în 23 martie. Și în data de 27 martie, la Târgul de Carieră, unde, Petre, suntem invitați și...
Da, aceleași condiții ca la Târgul de Carieră în IT, doar că va fi evenimentul dedicat tuturor pe care trebuie să facem, nu doar și în IT.
Ok. Ceea ce înseamnă că avem stand
vom avea stand, permisă de participare în aceeași. Toastmasters este asociat în organizarea evenimentului, vom avea un stand. Ce vom face noi, vom prezenta evenimentul și vom avea lucrurile care vor
ok. Până a doua și prima, când ne facem atunci. Nu să mai auziți de cel puțin trei ori
da.
Povestea asta. Bine, eu vă mulțumesc foarte frumos pentru prezența, implicare și vă aștept la Marti, sus în deal, unde mergem să avem o limonadă și să mai schimbăm.